Okay, well, I started the game recording mid-game on my flight. Just to explain what I'm doing, I'm actually I left Colorado Springs Airport at 3:05 left, and what I'm doing is I'm flying in the direction of between 40 and 55 degrees ish, and trying to navigate to Calhoun. And actually be able to go see some wind towers. And right now I'm actually gaining so much altitude that I probably wouldn't see very well. So I'm gonna lower my altitude here. But what I'm trying to do is navigate to these wind towers, this wind farm, and try to navigate back by instrumentation. Since I had started taking flying lessons way back in 1994, this is going to be completely new from the air. I actually took a road trip to New York at one point, and now I just want to see what the turbines look like from the air and kind of get a visual reference as to, like, looking at a man-made structure as a visual reference point. When flying, and I want to see if I can get a good navigation. I mean, we're going to be within visual range of these things. Perhaps I might fly over them and miss them. Should be fairly visible. I was doing my game recording things. That's why I was like trying to figure out how to do that. So. Because the wind currents and everything that they create do become a hazard to airplanes. I'm not going to get way too low or close to them because it will mess up my profile of my airplane. or my aerodynamic properties of the airplane with the wings. But we should get low enough to see what they look like. Yeah, that's what they look like, I guess, from the air. We ain't gonna do the Hollywood, let's lose them in the air, let's lose them in the, rotors of these wind turbines. It's kind of cool because I live right near the railway, and to see the blades and the rotors on these damn things is amazing. Modern marvels of the 21st century, I tell you what. For science, it's a great time to be alive. For political strife and racial tensions, it's pretty tough right now. This is way cool. Yeah, to see those things from the ground, it's hard to even describe how they are, how huge these things are in relation person on the ground. I mean, and you don't get a sense of their size from being just above them. They are massive, massive structures built by man. And they do serve a good purpose. I mean, renewable wind energy, so this is tied into the Colorado power grid, so it actually helps Colorado save money in energy consumption and fossil fuels, so I'm all about the science. I pretty much have to use everything I've learned in a lot of applied sciences in my schooling and my education all the way back to elementary school to be able to navigate fly an airplane. So, the best reference that we have in Colorado is going to be Pikes Peak, so I'm just going to use Pikes Peak off the center of the nose and get back home. I kind of know where the airport is in relationship to this mountain, so I was going to say, oh, I got to depend on instrumentation, but no, I don't. I just have to keep Pikes Peak right off my nose here. So that was a good exercise. I had to look at my chart and just kind of gauge where the wind towers were. So it's kind of between, I didn't even make note of the direction. I was tracking about 55 degrees magnetic north from the chart, and that was just a real quick look-see. But now I have a better sense of where it is in turning around from. So opposite 143 minus 180, I gotta make note of that real quick. about 63 degrees off the south end of Colorado. That'd give me a better heading, 63 degrees compass heading next time. Yeah, I was swinging a little too north, so yeah, that's right. So there's the Jump School Airport right off of the, just based on my right screen. So if I had enough problem and I had to get the aircraft down, that's a good place to stop. So I want to go between Meadow Lake Airport and the Callahan Jump School is the lane I want to take. So yeah. So yeah, it'll be easier to find those the next time around. I am making a continual slow descent back into Colorado airspace, so as I'm approaching back in, the AI co-pilot should inform the tower that our intentions are to land again. I'm in... I'm in Charlie airspace right now. So I should be transitioning into Bravo airspace here pretty soon. Clear to land,
runway 35 left, Cessna X-ray Golf Sierra.
Yeah, I need to learn. I need to get used to making long approaches and lead off speed. I'm not doing too, I'm coming in too fast on too many landings now. I need to practice that setup so I can get the field board better. Coming in hot's okay. when the situation calls for it, but it's not the most comfortable of landings. That was me trying different aircraft too, so I was like picking up different behaviors from my other airplanes. I need to go back to the Skyhawk 172 and just stick with that for a while longer. Maybe do some more practicing with this aircraft. I'm gonna go find General Aviation. It's at this end of the runway, so. I'm going to go ahead and stop the video right here, but I'm going to go ahead and park my aircraft. Thanks for watching. Hope you guys have a great day.